It is now time for our favorite segment. It's brought to you by Digi-Key and Adafruit. It is time for
Eye on MPI.
That's right. Eye on MPI.
That's right. With a great new theme song now.
What
okay.
is Eye on MPI this week?
This week's Eye on MPI is the MAX86150 combined pulse oximetry and EKG sensor chip.
Medical chips in the news.
From Maxim.
Medical chips in our new product introduction.
Right. Well, we did a pulse oximeter teardown as one of a video a couple weeks ago, and people in the chat were saying, well, how can I make my own pulse oximeter? And they're like, oh, there's this Maxim chip. So I kind of looked into, like, you know, what's up. And this is actually a more recent upgrade to the Maxim pulse oximetry chips. The 86150, what I think is interesting about it is it adds an EKG analog front end to it. So it's not only for blood gas, but also you can actually get, like, a pretty good EKG signal. I was actually trying out this test kit. So let's go to the overhead real fast, because I want to show this
off. We
have
a few things with this collection here.
Yeah, this is the dev kit.
And then we have, you know, what you wanted to show, and you actually have one here.
Yeah. Didn't know if I was going to get it in time, but I did. So here's the chip itself. Maybe I'll zoom in super close, because I want to show that, and I'll just focus in on it.
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
And the other thing we can do, tell me when is where you want it.
Hold on.
There you go.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's see if I can...
Oh my God, you're so close.
Yeah.
So you can see that this is actually... there's a chip inside, and you can see the two LEDs over here.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, this is pretty amazing. And then...
Oops. As soon as I say it's pretty good.
It's too much. Yeah, it doesn't... It's like
too much!
But you saw there, there's some LEDs.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, it's totally unhappy. This is so cool.
It does not like it.
Hold on. We went too much.
We went too far.
Can you zoom out? Okay. Sorry. Exciting times here at the overhead camera. So we've got a Maxim feather here, so that's kind of cool. We didn't pick this because it uses a feather and is basically a feather wing, but that's a nice bonus. So this is a Maxim Cortex M4 chip, and it's got a little Bluetooth module as well. And then here is, you know, the pulse oximetry chip. So to do the pulse oximetry, you put your finger over this, and you don't have to have, like, LED and sensor on two different sides. It actually bounces the light through the finger and then detects it on the same die, which is kind of nice because it's a simpler build. Also means it can go into wearables a lot easier. It can go to, like, a wristwatch or something that goes on your ear, for example, your fingertip. But it's an easier construction because you don't have to worry about light shining through the finger. You just need, you know, it to be close to the skin. And here's what's interesting. So these are two dry contacts for EKG or ECG measurements. So normally you have EKG where you have, you know, probe contacts go to, you know, left, right, and leg. Or maybe just left, right if it's a very simple one. For this one, you actually just put your thumbs on it, and it actually can measure your EKG through that. Like if you have seen gym equipment where you grab it with your fingers, or you have a little handheld EKG,
yeah.
It's the same kind of technology there. It's actually, it's a good enough analog front end. I tried it out, and you can really get EKG signal out of it. Another thing that's really nice about this, let's go to the photos.
Yeah, you have a few. We've got these.
Yeah, so here's showing how you can... You know, you put two fingers on and then a third finger on top to do the pulse oximetry. So it's a kind of a nice combo. And you see there's almost no components needed. There's only like a couple capacitors and resistors required. It's a very integrated chip, which I think is nifty. I even show like, they're like, here's all you need to hook it up. It has I2C out with an interrupt pin. So I think it's 1.8 volts, so you'll need a level shifter. But other than that, you can use it with like pretty much any microcontroller you like. And you get some really good bio data. I'm going to definitely make a breakout with this, maybe even like a feather wing, because this is such a cool chip. And I think people will definitely use this for projects. I'm also wondering if maybe the ECG can be used for muscle detection as well, not just heart rate. So, like, you can tweak all the filters and the gain and stuff. Yeah. I want to see what you can do.
What's cool is, like, you know, this is a feather format. Yeah. We're doing this ion MPI thing with DigiKey, and it happens to be a very useful thing that you hear about in the news right now.
Yeah.
So this is a good ion MPI this week, Lady Ada. So if folks want to get it, they should go to digikey.com and they should look for this part number.
That's right. So that's the part number for the individual chip. It comes in tray and also tape and reel. I've got a little piece of tape here. I got 10 sensors, so you can get it on tape.
Put it on the overhead.
Okay.
There you go.
So I can show you. The underside is, you know, a little bit complicated, but not too bad. It's definitely pick and placeable, reflowable, so integrated. It's not too inexpensive either. It's only a couple bucks. It's a great way to make a bio feedback or bio reading sensor circuit. And then the eval kit's very affordable too. I suggest picking it up because it has this nice Bluetooth connectivity software. So I got it running on my Windows machine in like 10 minutes. It was super easy. And we'll do a little write-up about it. And you can, you know, it starts graphing the data, you know, within a couple minutes of you downloading it and installing it. So a very easy sensor kit, nice work, Maxim.
And that is Ion MPI this week, brought to you by DigiKey and Adafruit.
Ion MPI.